All right, without further ado, we'll get started. So thank you so much for joining. Hello, I'm Rob Underwood, and I'm the Senior Support Engineer for Aquafadas. And welcome to the HTML5 WebReader Export Webinar. I'm so excited to finally be able to show you this new HTML5 export feature to all of our customers. For publishers and corporations, WebReaders are not only important, but they demand the same great user experience that they get on tablets using our digital publishing solutions. By creating an HTML5 web reader, publishers can put their content online and offer the same rendering as a native tablet app. Also, HTML5 makes your content SEO-friendly and easy to optimize for search engines like Google and Bing. As you know, the Flash Reader export option is already available in the Aquafadas digital publishing solution. However, web editions need to be compatible with 100% of browsers. Therefore, Flash is not an option anymore, as the technology is not supported by mobile navigation and has largely been abandoned for HTML5. An HTML5 web reader lets publishers target other platforms, because HTML5 is compatible with Windows tablets, Mac desktops, and any other device with web access. I'd first like to begin by showing you what this new HTML5 output looks like, and then I'll show you how this was created in InDesign and what interactivities are supported at the current time. And finally, we will talk about how you can customize your web reader. So for the first look here, this is an export to our HTML5 web reader output. You can tell, you know, if you've already been building things in InDesign and seen our Flash web reader, it's looks exactly the same as that content you're building in InDesign. The first thing that we saw here is we actually see this is an HTML5 animation. That was done out of Edge. So we do support, you know, any Edge animations that are done. You can also export out of Motion Composer, which is our native product. You can export as HTML5. That is also supported. Also, our frame-by-frame animation is supported. At the current time, the native InDesign animations are not supported, but that is on the running list, which we are going to talk about. And to give you a little tour here, we do have some zoom features just to begin with. So you can zoom in and zoom out. You can see how crisp that is. Let's go to a different page here. You'll notice that for the navigation, it's a little bit different than what we had within our Flash output. You now have arrows on the right and downward arrows for downward stacks or article navigation. This page actually has audio that is set to autoplay. I currently have that disabled because I didn't want to speak over it. So you can see I can downward arrow into other pages of this project. This is a scrollable frame. So scrollable frames are supported at the current time. You'll notice how crisp this is. So not only do we have the zoom in and zoom out feature, you also have a marquee feature. So you can actually marquee an area that you want to zoom into. Another great feature here is, of course, I am on my laptop and this is a scrollable frame and I can simply use the touchpad to scroll up and down within this scrollable frame. We also do have the ability to go full screen. And there's our full screen. You've also got a TOC or kind of a contents navigation that you can navigate from one article to the next. Very easy to do. And again, I'm going to scroll down into this article. Again, another scrollable frame just to kind of show you what's possible here. And again, this is audio that's set to automatically speak to you. And finally, I wanted to show you this is a slideshow. So our slideshow function is working here in our new HTML5 reader output. And also guided reading. We have guided reading applied to these three frames. So if I click, it simply zooms into the frame And again, just as you know, through our guided reading or our smart reading, it'll take me from frame to frame. Okay, so now that we've done a little overview of what this looks like, let's talk about InDesign and how you're going to set this up. So let's get out of the full screen mode. And let's go over to InDesign. Okay, so here's InDesign. And this is the project that I've built. Couple things just right off the bat here about setting up this project. Now, if you already have a project that was done for an app, so let's say you've already built it for iOS, and you want to now try this project out, you want to export it to HTML, a couple words of wisdom here. The first thing is I would duplicate the project because currently our enrichment list is not as robust as it is for iOS. So a couple words of wisdom would be to first create a new project, so click on the new project button and just make an empty holder for it. So you might call it, if you're working on, let's say you're working on March 2014, that issue, you're going to call this one March 2014 HTML5 WebReader export. Make a holder for it. And then, of course, you can duplicate your project. So if you have a current project, we do have the duplicate button. And what the duplicate button actually wants you to do is to move it into a new blank holder or blank project. Another word of advice is that if you're really excited about this and you want to try out HTML5 and you're thinking for your next issue, you're going to publish to, say, Android and iOS and HTML5 all at once, the word of wisdom would be to really get in here and embrace what you can do. Because, of course, you want to design once. If you want to just design once and have it go to all three platforms, then definitely you should find out what you are able to do here in HTML5. And that way, if you build it for HTML5, test it, and then test it in Android, and then test it in iOS, you can have one file that you can output to all of the platforms that we support. Just a little bit of words of wisdom. Of course, you can always have three separate projects and you can make them, but if you don't want to do all that rework, I would definitely start with HTML5. And as always, remember that using GoToAnchor is the best solution for page navigation when you are going to duplicate a project because article numbers change when that project is duplicated. Okay, since our early release of version 3 of our software, we have tabs set up in the AVE Interactivity panel on the left side. So as you're building your interactivities here in InDesign, you will notice that, as always, we've had AVE Mag, AVE PDF, and our two EPUB tabs. But what you're going to notice that is new here is that we now have Flash and HTML5. So currently, if I was building a blank frame, I can see what is now supported in version 1 of our HTML5 export. And of course, as time goes on, we do have a running list of things we are working on. And we do, we would appreciate feedback on, what you think should come next. So the next logical question is, well, what is supported? And here's the quick list. So for the reader itself, which we've just seen, the reader itself has full screen mode. It has zooming. You can navigate by either keyboard or mouse. Page preview navigation, which we saw up here, TOC up on the left. Retina compatible menu and buttons. Dual content navigation, which means navigation from right to left and left to right. Navigation by pages, so right to left, and by article up and down. Exceptional zoom, which we've seen with retina resolution rendering for images. We do support animated transitions between pages. And of course, the web reader is completely customizable. The background, the navigation buttons can all be customized. And we'll talk about editing that CSS later on. Now for what you really want to know here. So for the interactive enrichments, pictures, slideshows, audio and video, which as you would expect, HTML, which we've talked about, which you can build yourself, either on Edge or Motion Composer, guided reading, which we've seen, animated images, which is our frame-by-frame animations. We do support sublayouts and actions like go to web, go to article, show pop-up, change visibility, go to anchor, as you would expect. The fonts are embedded for perfect rendering on every screen, and the ability to render type as either an image for very complex layouts, or also you can render the type as type, which will make it completely indexable. We'll talk about that as well. It's compatible with all desktop browsers, Internet Explorer, Chrome, Safari, can be displayed on mobile browsers. Multi-touch function is not compatible at the current time. There are some known issues, which I'll tell you right now, kind of save you some time in your testing, is that go-to anchors work, but currently they do not work in sublayouts. Advanced buttons are not supported yet. The hover does not work. Ken Burns is not fully supported in Slideshow. And if you've tried this out at all, you know that if you render it as text, so not convert everything to an image, currently, copy text is disabled for the moment, but you should know that the text is still part of the HTML, and again, it's completely indexable and searchable, and again, animations can be done with Edge or animated image, and you can use Motion Composer too, but only in WebView for the moment. So what's next for version 2? What should you look forward to? Because you know we're always growing here at Aquafadas, and you know, the great part about this is that a lot of our games are already based in HTML. So what you're going to quickly see as new versions of this are released is enrichments like Quiz, Jigsaw, Memory, things that are going to be very easy for us to port over are going to be the first things to come over. Analytics will be next, and more mobile compatibility. We're going to have the ability to swipe a page when you're actually viewing it on a tablet. So we've got a running list. Also, I believe this went out with the newsletter. Of course, if you should always refer to our web reader and Android compatibility chart. We will give you access to this, so you'll be able to actually see what can and can't I do with this new output. Few recommendations. Now, all web browsers don't support the same multimedia types. It is therefore required to provide media files in multiple encodings to ensure proper running on all main browsers. And we also have a Google Doc that we can share with you concerning what is supported in each browser. Once you're done creating your rich interactive document for HTML5, you will be ready to export it and test it. So it's just like you've exported things before. Of course, now you're not going to be using our Aquafadas viewer. We're talking about actually making HTML. And of course, it's a two-part process, as you expect. Step one is to generate it, which I'm not going to bore you with today and click on the generate button. You know that it will be generated. And once it's generated, you can retrieve it. So I will just walk you through this, though. When you go to generate, you are going to notice that, you know, we've always had AVE, you know, so the ability to export to make a file that you're going to host within an app to create through us. We've always had, you know, for a while now we've had EPUB and web that used to just be Flash. But you'll now see that you do have a Flash button and an HTML5 button. You will need to assign a license if you want to fully process the whole thing. Otherwise, you're only going to get a few pages. That will be processed. So you will need a publishing license to try, if you want to fully try this out. You should know that that publishing license will let you choose either HTML5 or Flash. So you can kind of switch them out. So you can see right now I've got this already set to the HTML5 output. There are two preferences that we've already built in for you. HTML5 to images means that all the text will be made just to images for very complex layouts. As I've said before, the text in this will not be searchable and in the future selectable. And the one at the bottom is this actually makes this actually indexes all the text. It becomes part of the HTML, therefore it's indexable and searchable. You can also make your own preference here, which you know, all of this stuff has to do with how the user is going to interact with the page. Enable keyboard controls, for instance, or zoom slider. A lot of these things are already built in. So if you go to edit, say this one, a lot of these are already built in. The one thing that you definitely should be aware of is that you can choose, you know, when it makes this file for you, you can choose where it's going to save the theme CSS, the reader JavaScript URL, and the reader CSS URL. So if you wanted to put this, you know, you could actually sync this to the folder that's syncing to your website. So it doesn't have to always just be made into one single folder. That way, once you totally customize your reader, the look and feel, the background, you can actually store this in a central place and then have the pages point to that. We'll talk more about that in a minute, but you should know that you can customize where this CSS is going to go out to. Okay, so then once you process it, you would retrieve it. Of course, it's going to save this as a whole folder, and I'll show you what that folder looks like. So the folder comes out. You've got an index.html, so there's your first page. You will want to host this folder on your web server to get the best for, you know, exactly how it's going to look and feel, especially for movies and things like that. You really don't want to test it out on your own machine. You want to put this on a web server. Okay. We've got a couple folders in here, so you should know, you know, what these folders are all about. The OEBPS folder contains the files related to the document. The reader folder contains the core files that are common between documents. The only file you're really interested in here is the theme.css, which is in the reader folder, in the CSS folder, and here's the theme.css file. This is a template presenting all the styles you can edit safely, mainly the color and the icons of the reader. Let's actually open this up. I think I do have this open in Dreamweaver. Okay. And you can see that this is just a basic CSS file. It's divided into three sections, colors, icons, and high DPI icons. For the color section, you can use standard CSS color notation to replace default ones. As for the icons, the default values are relative URLs, but you are able to specify absolute URLs if you'd like. The high DPI icons are displayed in place of standard icons on devices with a high density of pixels, like Apple's Retina devices. They are the same as standard icons, but with double definition. Please note that when you replace an image, the new image must be the same size. And that, my friends, is the big overview of our new HTML5 WebReader export out of InDesign. We've seen the WebReader in action, how it was built in InDesign, and how you can fully customize it. All of us at Aquafadas look forward to seeing the amazing things you will create with this new tool set. And please feel free to contact us with your comments and suggestions. Again, I'm Rob Underwood, Senior Support Engineer for Aquafadas, and thanks for attending.